Hello, church family. Just wanted to give you an update of what we've got planned for the next couple of weeks as we transition through the month of May. It's hard to believe. It's been 6 weeks. This is week six since we've had an in-person church service. We've tried to be very creative and looking for different ways to be able to minister to our congregation, our church family. And I pray that God's been pleased with what we've done. We've certainly have tried to be a good steward of your lives and safety and protection, and all the while still trying to bring honor and glory to God through the process. We've had a great time the last couple of weeks as we've enjoyed services out in the parking lot, up on the pickup truck, and singing and preaching and honking the horns and all of that stuff. And we'll miss that as we transition to these phases of in-person church, but we've really enjoyed, and you folks, all of you, have been so great and patient as we've tried to make these different adjustments, and you've been flexible, and I appreciate that, and I know these are certainly uncharted waters for all of us, and I appreciate your prayers for your pastor, and as I seek to lead and guide our church in a way that would be first and foremost honorable and glorifying to our Savior, and also to be able to be a good testimony and citizen within our community. And we've certainly tried, and we as a church have certainly strived to accomplish that. I am excited though, as we prepare this Sunday, we've done all the preparation that needs to be done for those businesses that are allowed to be opened at this time with phase one. As I looked at our governor's phase one businesses reopening with various restrictions, we're going to be meeting each of these guidelines and even superseding these guidelines, because as a pastor, I certainly want our people, I want you to be safe, and I want you to feel safe when you come to church, more safe than you would go into a retail store, Home Depot, or a Costco, or a restaurant, or whatever, as some of those are opening up now. We want church to be a safe place, and we've always strived to do that with different procedures and protocols and things, and oftentimes they're an inconvenience and a bother, but it creates a safe environment for us. I know it certainly is worth it. Over these next several weeks, as we make some of these transitional and temporary adjustments, I pray that each of us would be very willing and submissive in regards to the different guidelines and things that we're going to be implementing, as we do want to be safe for those that are in attendance. As we look at phase one businesses are reopening, we see restaurants are reopening, pubs, wineries, bars, and breweries are reopening, barbershops, hair salons, nail salons are opening up, retail businesses opening up, the mall, malls, automotive, ATV, recreational vehicle dealers, entertainment, and got to get the cannabis stores opened up. And so all these different businesses are being opened up, and they're given different guidelines, stipulations of what our governor would like them to abide by. And that's our desire. We certainly want to follow all of the guidelines, and as I said a moment ago, to be able to go well beyond that. But it's time, as we look forward of God's people getting back to church, and I understand there may be some that may feel that you just don't feel comfortable as of yet coming back to church in an in-person, type in the facility type of church setting, and that's certainly fine. If you'd like to continue to come and park in the parking lot and listen to the broadcast via the FM signal, we want to encourage you to do that, and that'd be great. Or even others of you that may still want to choose to stay home and watch online, and that's certainly fine too. And we certainly don't want to put pressure on anyone, but we certainly want to make available, because there's many of us in our church family, as well as around the state and around the country, that are getting a little ready, getting stirred and anxious and ready to get back into church. And so we want to be able to make that available for those that feel comfortable for doing that. And so for us doing our part, we're putting a lot of preparation and time and expense as well to get everything ready in regards to you having a good, safe environment as you come to services on Sundays. And so there is a video that we've uploaded to our Facebook and YouTube account that we would like you to look at. It sort of gives you sort of a summary of what to expect when you come to church on Sunday or whenever, you know, when we're having our services. You'll be able to know what to expect, and we want all of us to be able to follow those protocols and procedures. To some, it may seem a little bit of an overkill and a little bit unnecessary, and it may be. But we want to do our due diligence, and we want to go the extra mile, as the Bible talks about. And so whatever is being required for businesses that are being allowed to open up now, we're going to meet those requirements and even go above that. And so please, I pray that you would follow through with all of the different stipulations. If for some reason you're just not wanting to submit to those guidelines and things of that nature, then we'd encourage you to go ahead and, you know, you continue coming to the parking lot, listening, or staying at home, because we want you to be comfortable and ready to when we can worship together. As we begin, we're going to have a revised service schedule. And so at 9 o'clock, right on time, we're going to start right at 9 o'clock. So if you're 65 years of age and older, or your health is a little bit, questionable, and you're just not really comfortable about coming to church with a lot of different people around and things of that nature, compromise the word I was looking for, then that would be the service for you to come to if you're wanting to come to church. So 9 o'clock, and everything is we've gone through, as I'll mention in a moment, sanitization, everything of that nature. But 9 o'clock, we'll be done. Just a little over 10, after 10, we'll be done. Be about an hour service, maybe an hour and 5 minutes, we'll be out of here. And as we prepare and transition for the next service, it'll begin at 11. That'll give our cleaning team time to come through and clean the sanctuary and the restrooms and places that the public has gone to. And it'll be very limited. It'll be very streamlined. So it's not going to be the whole building's going to be opened up. It's just going to be a designated areas where what we will occupy, and which will then allow us to have a designated area to clean. And that'll keep it a lot simpler and allow it to be a lot more streamlined as a result. 11 o'clock will be the main service. We'll have our evening service at 6 o'clock, same setup there, and then Wednesday night at 6:30. The Sunday night, Wednesday night service, if you're 65 and older or have a compromised health system, that's your call. If you feel comfortable coming to church and you like, the setup that we have and the sanitization and all that stuff, then you're certainly welcome to come. If you feel that you just want to come that 9 o'clock service or just stay home and watch online, we'll still continue the online services. That's fine too. Whenever you feel ready in these next couple of weeks that you feel comfortable to come back into church, then we want you to be there. We'll look forward to when we can see you, but we won't want you to feel pressured either way. And so wherever your call is and when you're ready for that. And so those will be all the services that we'll have. There's 9 o'clock, and then or the between 10:15 and 10:45, there's going to be a 30-minute pre-recorded Sunday school class. So those that are leaving church at 10, you'll be able to listen to that on your phone or when you get home on your computer, or as you're coming to church for the 11 o'clock service, you'll be able to listen to the 30-minute Sunday school lesson. So don't miss that from 10:15 to 10:45. And that half hour window is going to give our cleaning team time to go through and get everything prepped and ready and clean and ready for the next service to begin. And every service will be prepped and prepared in that way. You'll see that in regards to your health and wellness, we want you to make that call. The sanitization of our facility is being done in a very professional manner. We've got industrial grade cleaning agent that is able to deal with this COVID-19 and other viruses. The entire sanctuary is being sanitized, and the restrooms and those facilities and things that would be common area for the public. All of our in-person services are going to follow the same social distancing guidelines and sanitization guidelines that's outlined for stores, for restaurants, and businesses that are open during this time. And we believe that more essential than anything, the only business, if we can call it that, that's protected by the Constitution by name is the church. Walmart is not mentioned in the Constitution. We don't see retail stores in there, but the church is, and the freedom of religion. So we understand the importance, the essential, vital importance of church. And it's our spiritual nourishment, and it's also our spiritual strength to help us to be encouraged during discouraging time and comfort us during times of a discomfort. So the social distancing is very important. So as you walk in the sidewalk, we'll have red tape that'll be on the sidewalk at every 6 feet. One of our greeters will be out there monitoring, making sure everyone is maintaining their social distancing. We'll have our greeter at the door, and he'll allow you to enter in when there's space within the foyer area to come in. And there'll be several checkpoints of you know, the tape on the floor of the 6 foot area. And as you enter in, there'll be two tables set up on the side to where you'll have your temperature taken with a non-touch infrared thermometer, and making sure everything's well. There'll be a sanitized station there that you can sanitize your hands, or you can utilize the bathroom. It's right there together, and wash your hands. And so you'll need to do that. We're encouraging people to bring their own mask, if you so choose to wear those, it's not mandatory to wear masks, but we will have masks available. We'll have also the latex gloves available if you'd like to utilize those. But we are encouraging folks to bring their own masks, just to be able. It's a little bit difficult to get masks, and so we want those to last as long as we can. And then once you get that, then there'll be another person at the entry area into the sanctuary. Two different individuals that will then take you and or your family, and they will seat you. And so I understand that many of us have our own set aside seating areas, but we've got the sanctuary set up in a way where we've got a lot of sections that are just two chairs for a husband and wife or a single person. Then we've got another part of the church where there's five or six chairs that are grouped together that would be for the families. And so those that are escorting you in to see, allow them to seat you where they need to be seated. All seating is accommodating the 6 foot front, back, sideways, all around us in regards to 6 foot. They'll seat you there. And then once you're seated, please just remain seated. Restrooms will be open for emergency use, but we are encouraging people to utilize the restroom before you come. And once you're seated, remain seated. And then we'll have our service, and then we'll be dismissed the same way that you are entered in. So those same ushers will then be able to dismiss you accordingly. And as you dismiss, I'll be out in the courtyard area, so we won't bunch up in the foyer area. And then so we'll need to maintain that 6 foot spacing as well as we dismiss. And then we're encouraging folks, as you fellowship in the parking lot or the courtyard, you maintain that same social distancing for us, if you would please. And then, or immediately, go to your vehicle and head home and prepare for the next service. And so looking forward to all of those type of things that we're gonna be having together. And so, pray for tomorrow. I'm excited for Sunday. I'm doing this on Friday, so pray for Sunday. And we're excited about the services and being gathered together as a church family. And again, if you'd rather park in the parking lot, listen online at the radio station, FM, that's great, 98.5. If you wanna stay home and watch, that's fine too. But there's a lot of us that are healthy and strong, and we're excited to get back into church, and this will be our opportunity to gather together. But look at the video, and I'll sort of give you sort of a visual of what we're expecting and what to expect on our services. All right, looking forward to seeing you.